We are live from Portland, Oregon, for a Western Conference contest with the Trailblazers. Thanks for joining us, everyone. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan. Here with me today, Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. A quick check now at the starting lineups for both teams. And guys, checking out Damian Lillard, what can we expect here?
Well, Kevin, if things aren't going well out there, he's the one everyone on the floor looks to for an answer. I mean, he's their leader. He's the guy that drives them. And oftentimes, he will take it upon himself to right the ship when, you know, when things are not going well.
And, Steve, another of his special qualities is the way he always seems to up his game when there's something extra at stake. That never fails. You know, a big reason that the Nuggets were able to finish with the third best record in the West last season was they took care of business in the Western Conference. I mean, they went in every game against a conference opponent knowing what was on the line and handled business from there.
Now, here is Lawson with the teardrop. It's rebounded by Aldridge.
Well, with that much space off the pick, you've got to drop that in.
Yeah, you got to make that one. I mean, that's a high-quality shot you should make 9 out of 10 times.
And the officials call goaltending, so they'll award the basket. The record for the Nuggets against the West ended at 38-14. Just one off the mark of the Thunder. Steve, for the best record within the conference.
Seemed like every time there was ground to be gained, Kevin, in the playoff race, the Nuggets came through. Teams in the West like to run a little bit, but I don't think anybody could really run with Denver. That's how they were able to both win at home and win in the conference.
Lillard with it. Time for Batum. Aldridge sets up the pick now for Batum. 6 on the shot clock. From 15 feet away, Aldridge, no luck.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Lawson against Batum. Here's Fournier to the left wing. Gallinari with it. Matthews covering. A nice shot by Gallinari.
You gotta love the low post offense. That was beautiful.
On defense, Denver. Lillard attacking. He feeds it to Lopez. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
It makes it so easy for your teammate when you can lead him with a pass like that one.
Lillard against Lawson. And the pass to McGee. And it's good.
Fantastic pass. He turned that one into a pretty easy basket for his teammate.
The Trailblazers have gone 2-3 here to start out the game.
Well, you know, JaVale McGee was taken 18th overall out of Nevada back in 2008. You hear about teams reaching in the draft for size. Well, that wasn't the case this time. You look at this kid's physical gifts. I mean, the tallest standing reach in the NBA, he stands alone in that category.
Here's Lawson after the made shot from Lopez. High arcing shot. The shot's good from Lawson. Lawson's got his first points in this one. For Portland, they've gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Lillard attacking. That's good. And for JaVale McGee, not just long, but also athletic to think of him in the dunk contest, dunking two balls on two baskets at once. It was a very creative way to go at it.
It's incredible to watch McGee out on the floor, dunking, blocking shots, running like a leader. Still very young, 25 years of age, but he can get a lot better, I think, with his game as he develops his skills.
This game's going to take a big swing. Clark, if the Duke continues to clear out like that and give up easy dunks.
Yeah, that's the kind of defense we expect to see in a blowout, Kevin, or even an exhibition game, not a close game like this.
Look and how frustrated Steve is over this.
Well, I just,
his head.
You know what,
oh, he's
Kevin?
Disgusting.
Come on, Kevin. I just like that he didn't choose to just lay it up there. I mean, he threw it down with force.
A dunk by Fareed.
Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered it down.
And that's the play we're going to remember when this game is all said and done.
Trailblazers trail by 4. Now, here's Lillard. Outside Matthews. Feeds to Aldridge. The turnaround. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. And pushing it up, here's Denver. Gallinari leading the charge. Got that one up quick. Gallinari's got 6 points.
Everything going according to the script for them offensively so far.
Yeah, the shots have been falling, that's for sure. The offense really in a good groove.
Now, here's Lillard. Fades away. And Aldridge gets it to go on the assist by Lillard.
Smart. Use that big height advantage. Get the shot off.
Well, it's hard to put a big man on him, Steve, that far from the hoop. I mean, he's versatile.
So here's Gallinari. 6 points for him. Here's Fareed. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
These defenders look overmatched right now, especially inside.
Yeah, you look at the numbers. 10 of the last 12 points have come from close range, so I agree.
Batum, good.
The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very, very well done.
And Lawson, here we go. That is good. Lawson's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Yeah, that's 5 of their last 6 baskets inside the lane. They have really established themselves inside.
So timeout called here, the first for Portland. Big group substitution here for Denver. J.J. Hickson, he's checked in for JaVale McGee. Arthur comes in for Fareed. Wilson Chandler's checked in for Gallinari. And Andre Miller has subbed in for Fournier. Trailblazers trail by 6. Williams passes to Robinson. Inside. And Leonard gets it to go.
They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Yeah, they've been the aggressors, Clark, and getting the ball inside into that lane area has been huge for them.
That's good. 6 points for Lawson.
And they're making a statement here, guys, going inside for 8 of their last 10 points.
Time to man up on D and stop these free runs to the rim.
Oh, here's Wright. It's Matthews on the wing, covered by Miller. For 3, Williams, and that is good. Williams has got himself on the board with 3 there.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yes, Kevin, I caught up with Brian Shaw. He said the player he'll be watching closely in this matchup is Thomas Robinson. He added, you have to respect the energy he brings to the game. That'll be the challenge for our bigs, is matching that energy and physicality. Guys, Robinson, a guy with a growing skill set, but it's still that athleticism and hustle that's really his calling card. Back to you.
Thanks again, Doris. Now, Lawson. He's got 8. Passes it to Chandler. That one falls, coming off Lawson's feet.
All the points these defenders are allowing inside is inexcusable. That's 5 baskets in a row, and they've all been practically lay-ins.
Yeah, they've got to harden and toughen up down there, guys.
Now, here's Matthews. Outside, Williams. And he gets it to go. Williams has got 5.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist number. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
Ty Lawson again.
Great move to the hoop, and I love the finger roll finish.
With 1 on the clock, can't hit. A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through 1. Nuggets lead by 5. From Portland, we're back in a moment. The second quarter beginning in just a moment. Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so far for the Nuggets.
We've seen a lot of their points coming off penetration in this first half.
You know, it also hasn't taken them long to make their mark in the paint. I mean, they're doing a lot of their scoring from in there.
So out there for the Nuggets right now, we've got Arthur. Andre Miller is out there with Evan Fournier. And there's Hickson. And it's Chandler in at the small forward. And there's the rejection. Miller against Batum. Chandler outside. The jump hook misses off the left iron.
I'll tell you what, for what's really an elementary shot, he looked a little nervous on that release. You know, it's always a challenge adjusting from college to the pro game, particularly when you talk about the size of the NBA big man. When Thomas Robinson struggled his rookie season, he really started to lock into watching tape of another undersized power forward, Mr. Paul Millsap, as a way to try to improve his own game.
Here's Robinson after the made shot from Arthur. Count the bucket.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
And Denver has possession. 3-point lead. Miller with the ball. Williams picks him up, and it's Miller penetrating. Nice shot from 10 feet out. Back to Thomas Robinson. Like Millsap, a terrific rebounder in college. He led all big-time NBA prospects in the 2012 draft in overall rebound rate.
And that translated to his rookie season, Kevin, where he had problems finishing. You know, rookie field goal percentage of 43%.
Williams gets the bucket.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Clark, just piling up points in the paint.
Now here's Arthur. Here's Miller. The shot from the low post is good. Miller's got his second basket of the game. Trailblazers trail by 5. Leonard with a screen on Miller. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there.
Well, if you're going to set a screen like that, you've got to make sure your feet are set.
I agree with you, and I thought maybe he was set that time, Steve. I thought it was a good screen on his part.
A different look for Denver. JaVale McGee's checked in for Hixon. Fareed comes in for Jarrell Arthur. And it's Gallinari in for Wilson Chandler. Fournier, that one goes. Count it. And the Nuggets lead by 7.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
Now, here's Lillard. And it's out of bounds to Portland. He'll retain possession. Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Count that one.
Well, he's so good at recognizing where the openings are and getting the ball to the rim.
Denver leading by 5. Miller dishes to Gallinari. Plays it up and banks it in. Gallinari's got 8.
Well, it's pretty obvious, guys. Portland has a lot of young talent, but the defensive effort has to get better. The intensity, the concentration at that end of the floor has to grow, which is always tough with a young team, but to get better, it's going to have to start with defense there.
And that one's good by Aldridge.
He has great dexterity inside. He can contort his body, shift in midair, hang time, he can protect the ball and finish through contact. Just an impressive player in the paint.
And Steve, that's not a skill that most players have. I mean, that's exactly why they try to feed it to him in the paint whenever possible. And Steve, you know, he's also got a full arsenal of moves in the post. I mean, you can't believe how many tricks this guy has up his sleeves. He's full of them.
Now a timeout called by Portland. Portland finishing second to last in opposing team shooting percentage, Clark. Yeah, that's interesting. Defense, something that usually needs to be learned in the NBA. And the Blazers were a young team last season, Steve, and easily a team learning game by game.
Yeah, youth or not, though, Kevin. I mean, 48% against you defensively in terms of field goal percentage. That can't happen. So a lot of improvement in store for this Portland team. They really have to lock in on the defensive end.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Yes, Kevin. Brian Shaw had some words for his team in that last timeout. He spoke very adamantly about being much more active in defending the perimeter shot, saying, no more soft defense on the perimeter. I want you guys all over their shooters. Well, coach not wasting any time when speaking the game plan. We'll see if it makes a difference as we approach halftime, Kevin.
And thank you, Doris. Now, here's Lillard following the miss by Andre Miller. Shot is good, and the Nugget lead is cut down now to just 4 in the basket from Lopez.
Fantastic pass. He turned that one into a pretty easy basket for his teammate.
Miller, no up.
Well, what appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
And Lillard kicks to Alden. Kicks it out to Lillard. Good ball movement here by the Trailblazers. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession.
Boy, just a brain cramp, guys. I mean, that should have been the simplest of exchanges.
Ty Lawson, he's checked in for Denver. Here's Fournier. Wasson outside to JaVale McGee. And Lopez with the block. And it's out of bounds to the Nuggets as Denver retains possession. Lawson gets the screen from Gallinari. Three-pointer, and it's Ty Lawson with the three. Lawson's got 13 points.
The screenplay worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screenplay you see in a movie theater. It gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
And he gets the bucket.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Nicely done.
Denver leading by five. And it's sent back by Aldridge. The shot's good from Fareed.
Things have changed a little bit here in the second quarter, guys, and we're seeing them start to convert a lot of second-chance opportunities.
Yeah, and I'm sure the coach has to be happy about this. I mean, the hustle underneath is paying off in a big way.
Now, here's Matthews. Aldridge left side. Offensive rebound. The shot's good from Lopez.
Well, their plan of attack has been pretty clear to see. You get the ball inside and just take it strong to the hoop. Be dominant in the lane.
Well, the defense has been very slow to adjust. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
And Matthews throws it down.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
Just one thing to create a turnover, but to so inertly turn it into a transition opportunity. That's even better.
Here's Fournier. Jacks up a three. That is in there. Lawson with the assist. Lawson's got four assists in the game.
That's like a layup for him. He's just wide open out there.
Lillard with it. Now Lawson defending. Lillard, the pass to Lopez. Stolen by Fareed. And they call an illegal screen here.
Well, if you're going to set a screen like that, you've got to make sure your feet are set.
I agree with you, and I thought maybe he was set that time, Steve. I thought it was a good screen on his part.
And the Nuggets with some changes. J.J. Hickson, he's checked in for JaVale McGee. Arthur comes in for Kenneth Faree. And Wilson Chandler subbed in for Gallinari. Now, here's Lillard. He's got six. Right outside. Chandler with the steal. And pushing it up, here's Denver. And Lawson gets it to go on the assist by Chandler. And now an 8-point Nugget lead.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Right from outside, and he gets it to go. Wright's got himself going there, his first points of the game on the deep ball. Here's Lawson. No good. And the first half ends in a close one. Nuggets ahead. They lead by five.
Presented by Sprint.
Welcome, I'm Damon Bruce. A great game going on out in Portland. The Nuggets playing with poise so far. They've been putting a lot of defensive pressure on the other team, taking care of the rock offensively, fundamental basketball, both sides of the court. Ty Lawson in the first half, amazing. Seems like everything's falling for him. Not sure if he even knows how to miss. And hanging tough, the Portland Trail Blazers. A dominating performance offensively. They're getting everything they want. The first half, a productive one for Damian Lillard. He's got 6 points, and he's stacking up the assists too, keeping the defense off balance with his passing. And we'll be heading back to the court for the rest of our coverage as we go to Kevin Harlan, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke for the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. What a game we're seeing from Ty Lawson.
Well, in terms of his points in the first half, I mean, that's pretty much what we've come to expect.
Fourth quarter. And how about a look now at our assist of the game? Brought to you by State Farm.
Flawlessly to set up that alley-oop.
Here's Lawson. Taking a look at the Nuggets. We've got Wilson Chandler. Arthur out there with Hickson. And it's Miller. And it's Lawson in at the point guard.
Just seems like they're finding an open lane to the hoop every time down. A that's five buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Here is Matthews. Ty Lawson making his last shot.
Good on that shot, and with that, the Nugget lead is cut down to six on the bucket from Wright.
Denver's gone a very strong 4-for-5 from three-point land in the ballgame. Lawson kicks to Chandler. Off target with the open look.
Well, as far as jump shots go, that's as high percentage as it gets.
I'm not sure how that didn't go down.
Matthews dishes to Wright. Off target with his three. The Nuggets leading by six. And it's Miller penetrating, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
What a display of offense we've seen today, and it's only getting better.
Well, both defenses have been on their heels all day, and it's begun to take its toll.
Now, here's Matthews. There's the dish to Williams. A shot, no good. And Denver the other way now. He's feeling it, and it's Lawson. That time on the assist by Chandler. And it's a 10-point Nugget lead.
He has really punished these defenders today. No matter who's been on him, he's been giving them medicine.
Now a timeout called by Portland.
Wilson Chandler was one of those guys who decided during the condensed season to play in China. Took him a while to get back to the NBA, and when he did, a hip injury kept him on the sidelines. But last season, he seemed to regain his earlier form.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Hi, Kevin. I was able to hear the advice Terry Stotts gave to his team during that last break. He let his players know that they've got to do a better job on defense. He said, they're scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
That's good. 8 points for Batum. And Wilson Chandler, 26 years of age, athletic, physical. The Nuggets gave him a nice five-year contract on this basis of his potential.
Well, he's one of the players they got in the Carmelo Anthony trade. He's tough, low-maintenance guy, competes at both ends of the floor, and can really shoot the three ball well, too. I think he complements what Denver has tried to do here in recent years, playing that up-tempo style and yet maintain that floor spacing in the half court.
Here's Chandler. Ty Lawson making his last shot, and it's good. And let's get your guys' take now on the hustle stats for the Nuggets.
Their activity at the defensive end, Kevin, has been really impressive, attacking and coming away with steals.
Something else they've done is force a lot of mistakes defensively, and they've been turning those turnovers into points.
How about that for a response?
We will say they can give the three as well as they can take the three.
And he gets it to go.
He is just tearing it up this court. That lead's not going anywhere while he's this hot.
Now here's Williams. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Here's Aldridge. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up. 14 points for Aldridge.
There's been a change in his game compared to what we saw in the first half. I mean, he's scoring with a lot of confidence now.
Arthur kicks to Hixon, and the layup's good off the glass. And the Nuggets lead by 12.
Textbook right there. Nice pass, great catch, beautiful finish.
Williams up on top. Lawson defending. Outside for Batum. Into LaMarcus Aldridge. That's good. Aldridge has got 12 points here in the second half.
Well, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
And Lawson, here we go. Pulls it up. And again, it's Denver.
He's doing it all for them right now on the offensive side. No matter what the defense has done, they haven't been able to find an answer to stop him. And he's had an answer for every defense he's seen.
And Matthews kicks to Batum. That drops. Batum's got 7 now in this quarter.
Kevin, he does a great job of moving without the ball. And he gets a lot of good looks because of that movement. And as long as his teammates are setting screens and looking for him, he can be lethal from the outside.
And that is the key, Steve. But his release in those catch-and-shoot moments is also terrific. And also, there aren't many players better at anticipating an opponent's next move, waiting for his moment and then jumping in the way of a pass to come up with the steal. He's got that master.
Williams with the ball. Now Lawson defending. Aldridge, the pass to Batum. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits.
I'd love to see them impose their will a little bit more on the backcourt. Usually that's a great way to take control of the game.
Well, they haven't been able to do that yet, but it's something they're certainly capable of. Heads-up play there, guys, on the assist and defense.
The Nuggets leading by 10. Out to Chandler. And Lawson with the drive. The feed now to Hixon. That one falls, coming off Lawson's feet. Lawson's got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. They're trailing by 12. We've got 1:48 left in the game. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Terry Stotts as he addressed his team. He started with discussing how they wanted to defend against Lawson. Coach reminded his guys how he had simply picked apart their defense. And while Coach went on to say that while nobody is going to completely shut him down, they simply must limit his productivity.
Thank you for that, Doris. Trailblazers trail by 12. Lillard dishes to Aldridge. And that one hits back iron. Denver's gone a terrific 5 of 6 from beyond the arc in this game. Kicks it to Gallinari. And Lawson with the drive. Here's Fareed. Makes it off the glass. And the Nuggets lead by 14.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively. I mean, what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
Now, here's Lillard, and the dunk by Aldridge.
And there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. A statement victory for the Nuggets.
Good point, Steve. And Clark, they had to battle for this win. There were times when it looked like it was maybe slipping away a bit, but they never let that happen, which I thought was a real credit to them.
I like their fortitude, their toughness, particularly in terms of dealing with adversity. Anytime things didn't go their way, they just put their nose down and stayed with it. And because of that, they were able to pull away.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Ty Lawson. Just an outpouring of points from him. Nobody could do anything, really, to stop him.
Just the shot they wanted, point-blank range.
Now Hixon inside. And he can't jam it through.
I like his tenacity getting to the basket there, even though the dunk rattled out. 99 times out of 100, he'll get the dunk or the foul.
You know, his finishing ability leaves a lot to be desired, guys. He needs to take it to the basket stronger.
Lawson outside. And so it's Denver taking care of business in this one. Not much to be critical of with this win, Clark.
Not at all. I mean, they showed up not just to play. They showed up to give great effort and to win, and they did both.